The law of relativity, another universal law.
God allows us to experience the low points in life in order to teach us lessons we could not learn in any other way. The law of relativity begins with our understanding that each of us is provided with problems or a test of initiation. These tests are designed to assess where we are on our spiritual paths and what experiences we need to learn. Our response to these tests is important to our spiritual growth. On the one hand, we can compare ourselves to others and say, why me? Why am I experiencing these problems when others do not experience the same problems? We choose our response to these tests, and that response can advance or retard our spiritual progress. When the heart and mind are connected, we realize the meaning of the test and know that failure simply means that the next test will be more difficult. In this positive frame of mind, we say, thank you, masters, for this test of initiation. When we look at our problem, we consider that it might have been worse or more difficult. The ways in which we view the world begin and end with our own minds and the meanings we choose. As we move on our spiritual paths, we are able to see the positive aspects of our experiences, even the El Morai speaks to us on the law of relativity. This message on the law of relativity is protected in the light of the Most Radiant One and transmitted with the vibration of the Highest. It speaks of observation and choice, and teaches the importance of applying the law of vibration to the choices each makes. Inherent in understanding, the law of relativity is an awareness of the test of initiation, which are lessons that all must learn to become enlightened. These tests determine how quickly the soul advances on the spiritual path, and how many times it must be reborn on the earth plane for the purpose of making choices again. I, El Morai, speak with the wisdom of my soul commanded when I was Solomon centuries ago. It is with great pleasure that I come forth today and transmit my understanding of this most important law. Although the law of relativity has been in existence as long as the universe, it received its current name from the Pharisees of old. The Pharisees I speak of were the ones who lived with the age of when the age of Pisces was new. These learned ones understood the importance of maintaining a higher standard of living while practicing spiritual laws. Many who resided in Israel enjoyed the status of their positions and protected their ranks by citing the laws as the defense for their actions. They spoke with precision, for they had memorized the laws, and their minds understood the impeccable application of these statutes in the world. They were, however, remiss in one count. Their hearts were not connected to the spirit of the law. An intellectual interpretation of the law often differs from the spiritual intent, which was usually the reason the law was created in the first place. Unless a soul is sufficiently advanced to accept the spirit of the law, its meaning and intent often are lost in the winds of time. The law of relativity is one of the laws that has been lost in the winds. Basically, the law of relativity assures that each soul will receive a series of tests, problems, if you will, designed for the purpose of strengthening the light within. As each soul is tested and provided with opportunities for advancement, options are given that guide the possible choices to be made. These options allow the soul to use the understanding of the law of vibration for either advancement or regression. Everything in life is relative, O sisters and brothers on the path. All is the all. There are no judgments regarding good or bad, better or worse. Everything is relative, balanced within the mental and emotional state of the person in any given moment of time. The reason one believes that things are better or worse is because the mind makes comparisons with people, things, and events that are not relevant, and applies these comparisons to the present situation. Each event in one's life stands alone and should not be compared with other things. This is because each event has its own vibrational frequency with unique lessons to learn and should be analyzed from the perspective of what is it I am to learn from this situation. Instead of approaching life from this perspective, individuals frequently choose to compare their lives and situations with those of others, and it is through these comparisons that they often become depressed, believing that others are more blessed than they are. The law of relativity speaks to the fact that all things are known only through their relationship to the mind. The mind controls how one feels, what one believes, and how one behaves. It is a powerful tool and God's gift to humanity. But the mind can be too clever sometimes, especially if it becomes disconnected from the heart. Too much analysis or reason sway one from seeing the higher truths. When this occurs, the individual becomes attached to the letter of the law and not to the spirit of it. This is what happened to many of the Pharisees of old. The law of relativity brings clarity to the mind, for it cautions individuals not to compare current problems to former ones. Instead, the law guides each soul to look at challenges as opportunities for advancement and learning. Since each will be presented with the test of initiation, and everybody's test will be different, it becomes obvious that the journey in life is not about comparisons, but about mastering the lessons each has come to learn. The law of relativity is considered to be one of the more advanced laws. The key to using this law effectively comes through the control of one's mind. When one learns to use the mind to focus only on the present situation, the soul is free to pursue new and higher solutions for problem solving. Learning to analyze each moment of time, staying connected with the heart, is the key to freedom. The law essentially reveals that in every moment of one's existence, the soul is provided with choices. The ultimate goal is to choose that which is beneficial and good for advancement, thus creating a higher frequency within. When one does not understand this law, great repercussions may develop because choices made, not connected to the heart, can bring heavy returns of karma. When people are pious and feel that they are in a state of grace, they sometimes act righteously. They sometimes act unrighteously. I don't know if I printed that right. This is especially true of those who have memorized the law. They act righteously, like as if they are can do no wrong, I guess, is what they're saying here. In this frame of mind, they can be compared to the Pharisees. Keep in mind, O children of earth, that the souls of the Pharisees are still caught in the wheel of rebirth. The choices they made did not take into consideration the importance of the connection to the heart. Make all choices from the heart center, and the wheel of rebirth will no longer chain you to the third dimension. Let the law of relativity guide your understanding and set you free to pursue other forms of existence. Come, join us in the fifth dimension and higher. We shall teach you the higher truths that you are seeking to learn. All you need do is to assure that each choice you make is aligned with a higher frequency, and you shall quickly advance on the steps of the high initiate. May the Creator of all watch over your every footstep. Go in peace. I am El Moriai. And I just want to interject here that the story of the Good Samaritan would be a good example, I think, of that law, because the priest that passed by the man on the side of the road who needed help, they had to be about their righteous work in the synagogues or the temples. And so they couldn't be bothered to do something like help a person. So they were not connected with their heart centers, but they did have higher truths that they divorced the spirit of love from. so it made them of no effect. I think that's what that story presented, because Jesus said it was a Samaritan who befriended the guy left on the side of the road, and the Samaritans were specially known to not believe as the Hebrew children, the children of Israel believed. They considered them so wrong in how they believed that they really even hated them and would often walk around their land to avoid walking through their land, so because they detested them so much, because according to them, they didn't believe right. But the Good Samaritan had a good heart, and Jesus was trying to show that how you act is more important than the things you say you believe. It's your actions and not the letter of the law that he was bragging on in the Samaritan. So the next chapter is going to be on the law of polarity, and I will start it with the next session.